What's up, guys? It's your boy Blu-rayDave back with another video, and there was one more thing I forgot to tell you guys in the previous video, but honestly, I think let's just be glad that I didn't say that in the previous one, because I'm trying to make that video positive, but now I don't want to be negative on here, guys, but I just need to tell you this. Ever since, how do I even say this? Ever since, I don't know how to explain this. So, let's just bear with me here, guys. I don't want to get speechless here, but, I don't know. April and May, and starting this month of June, they have been really getting to me since, like, the 25th of April, and going through the rest of the days of this month in June, because, guys, if you remember what happened last summer, because, yeah, last summer, it didn't even feel like 1 year, like, it just felt like a few months. So, my camera just froze, so, I really hope I don't get emotional with this, so, let's talk about this. So, reasons why these months were getting emotional to me, because, again, I'm not going to say, but they've been affecting me so much because of, like, what happened last year, and it's still affecting me today, guys, because last June, when, like, after 11th grade, I couldn't see this special someone after that, because I thought we were gonna, like, still hang out with each other through the summer until Father's Day, June 17th. I don't know when Father's Day. What the? My camera's being stupid again. Sorry. But I don't know when Father's Day is gonna be on this day. Is that on the 17th? Probably not. Probably on the same day, like Sunday. Like, anyways, June 17th hit pretty hard for me because I had an emotional breakup. Because here's the thing: the same day on Father's Day, I woke up with the most horrifying. This wasn't even a dream; it was a vision. This is not the first time I had a vision. And what this vision was telling me was that I was going to go through a really bad breakup, and I was telling my brother about it. I'm like, I hope it doesn't happen. But that later that evening, that's when, for me, the unthinkable happened. And I'm like, what? I could have shouted at this person on Messenger, but nope, I just kept calm about him, just like, you know what, it's fine. But later that night, I was crying, guys. That was another depressing summer, because I couldn't handle breakup. So, this year on the 17th, it would be 1 year ago that day, but I'm not gonna make a video on it, guys, because, you know, I just don't want to talk about it. I did explain a whole lot about it the day after on a YouTube video, so if you want to check that out, please go check that out on Blu-rayDave Season 3. So, these 17 days of June, they're really going to hit me hard, guys, because I couldn't even see that special person until I went back to the high school, and I'm not sure if I'm going to see her again in person. But she does want to hang out in the summertime, so let's not assume that we're not going to see each other again at all, guys. So she will be a junior this year, and the next year she'll be a senior. So I'm hoping, I mean, I don't know, I'm hoping we'll still hang out. Guys, before I graduated, I told her how I felt about her. She completely understood it. She's still not ready yet because she went through a breakup in November. And I'm not gonna explain that, guys, so yeah. It's best that I'd rather not. But I kept telling her how I felt about her, and who knows, guys. I mean, I don't deserve a second chance. I mean, I thought I could do everything in my power to be the better boyfriend that she wanted me to be, but I mean, I tried to find other dates, guys. I tried, but the only other person I could think of, and I think about her every day, is just her, you know. She was like the person that I was really in a deep committed relationship, and I'm just like, man, I wish I could do all those again, and I wish I could take back what I said to her, you know. Like, I made some like jokes, but they were pretty bad, so I'm like, well, I'm never doing that again. Still, we still get along pretty well, you know, as friends. Still, like I said, who knows, guys, what could happen in the future. I already asked somebody out, like I said in the previous video, I already asked somebody out before I graduated. Still, she says she's going to think about it, even though I've known her since second semester of this year. So, her and I have gotten along pretty well. And I just want to know if we could both date, but she's still thinking about it. But anyways, back on to, like, these days. I know the 17th will hit me pretty hard. I'm going to have a lot of deep memories about it. I don't want her to feel bad about it, okay? Because it was her decision. She gets to decide what she wants to do, and I can't make the decision for her, so. Sure, I still feel pretty bad about it, because when that breakup happened, I immediately started thinking about things like the things that I've done, like, oh, I didn't think she would take them that personally, but she did. She did block me throughout the entire summer. Well, until like August before my, or maybe it was during my brother's birthday. Like, she followed me on Instagram again. I know she had her reasons why she blocked me on social media. I don't blame her. But I did end up blocking her maybe a couple times on Instagram. But I'm not going to do that again, because if she's going back into another relationship in junior year, I'm not going to block her. If she has any advice for me, I can just tell her, like, just do this or that, or don't do this or that, and maybe your relationship will go smoothly. I needed a hug from her, so we hugged before my last day of school ended, because I'm just like, this could be the very last time that I will see her in person. But then again, we don't know, guys. I just don't know. So we'll just keep our, I guess, like, high hopes up, I guess. I can't think of anything else, but, still, if she still wants to be friends, that's okay. Maybe one day, I mean, I know she's told me how she felt about me, but if she wants to tell me more, worst stuff, how she felt about me, she can tell me, but I won't tell you that guy's on YouTube video, so that's just how it's going to work. Because I can't post any stuff like that on YouTube because it could affect me, my friends, my family, so. I know she works at a movie theater, and she, like, both me and my sister, we went to go see Endgame the day it came out, and then she checked us out, so that was pretty cool. I did remember seeing her and her mother at Cub, but we were at different, like, aisles, I guess. I was shopping at the time after work. I'm like, okay, because I was scared, guys, because I was like, should I even go talk to her? Still, her and I, we both told each other we're there for each other no matter what. So. Guys, do you have any advice for me? What could I have done to be the better boyfriend? How could I improve? How could I mature on this? What type of responsibilities could I take for that? I've apologized to her a few times. Because I wasn't really a good friend to her. Again, I don't want her to feel bad about me because... Yeah, just... I just want to keep it simple, guys. Just getting very emotional about it. Alright, that's pretty much all I have to say. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed. Please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't already. I think I'm getting a little emotional right now, guys, but I'm just trying my best. Still, I just hope our friendship could go strong. Even when we first met, when I was a junior, when she was a freshman, I immediately knew we were going to become best friends. Also, she's friends with my brother, the Eradicator, so I guess that would make sense. there's nothing wrong with that, guys. It's good to have connections, you know. So, my brother, he was on board with us. He thought, like, he told me, like, oh, you guys make a great couple, and as soon as we started dating, he's like, oh, man, you guys are an awesome couple. And I appreciate him for telling me those things. Alright, thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks, bye-bye, man. Lord, be with you guys. Always love you guys. Peace out.